What you're looking at is the so-called Monoceros, the unicorn constellation. Monoceros is a faint constellation in the celestial equator. It is bordered by Orion on the west, Gemini to the north, Canis Major to the south, and Hydra to the east. It contains only a few fourth magnitude stars, making it difficult to see with the naked eye. It is usually best visible at latitudes between 75 and minus 90 degrees. The brightest star, Alpha Monoceros, has a visual magnitude of 3.93. Beta Monoceros isn't a single star. It is actually a triple star system. The three stars form a fixed triangle, and astronomer William Herschel discovered the triple system in 1781, calling it one of the most beautiful sights in the heavens. But besides the stars, this constellation keeps many more secrets. For example, it contains two super-Earth exoplanets, two open clusters such as M50 and the Christmas tree cluster, named for its resemblance to a Christmas tree, the famous Rosette Nebula, the Cone Nebula, and much more. It is a unique constellation with unique features, and astronomers say it's not over, because they have found evidence for a candidate black hole that resides in this constellation, and they dubbed it the Unicorn. Keep watching the video to get to know more about the fantastic world of black holes and unicorns. I promise you won't regret it. So let me ask you a silly question. Do you believe in unicorns? Because I do, and apparently even astronomers take their existence into high consideration. Joking aside, a team of astronomers found the closest known black hole to Earth, a weirdly tiny object. And they dubbed it the Unicorn because it resides in the constellation Monoceros, making it one of the most interesting constellations of our night sky. It is one of the closest black holes to Earth at a distance of 1,500 light years. I know what you're wondering. Why the Unicorn? Well, the nickname seems to have a double meaning. Not only does the black hole candidate lie in Monoceros, but also it is incredibly low mass, about three times that of the Sun. Makes it nearly one of a kind. Because the system is so unique and so weird, you know, it definitely warranted the name of the Unicorn. Discovery team leader Tharindu Jayasinghe, an astronomy PhD student at The Ohio State University, said in a new video the school made to explain the find. By the way, we said the black hole weighs three solar masses. How much is three solar masses? Let's do some calculations. The Sun's mass is about 1.98 times 10 to the power 30 kilograms, which is to say that this small black hole weighs about 6 times 10 to the power of 30 kilograms. Just for a term of comparison, let's consider some other well-known black holes. For example, the famous M87 black hole, the one black hole that spread all over the world thanks to the beautiful pic astronomers took, is about 6.5 billion suns. It's huge. Another famous black hole is the one at the center of our Milky Way, Sagittarius A star, and it has a mass of about 4 million solar masses. In this sense, we say the Unicorn is a tiny and peculiar black hole. Very few such super lightweight black holes are known because they're incredibly hard to find. Black holes famously gobble up everything, including light, so astronomers have traditionally detected them by noticing the impact they have on near objects. In fact, black holes are black, and we can find them only considering the impact they have on their surroundings, mostly stars. At this point, it should be clear that we can't directly observe a black hole, which could lead to the question, so how did astronomers find the evidence for the Unicorn in the Monoceros constellation? What were they looking at? Which instruments did they use to detect it? Before finding out the answer to this question, be sure to like or dislike the video, so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel by clicking the bell, so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Most of the time in the universe, we find objects that are gravitationally connected. Binary systems of stars, star systems like the solar system, pulsars that have started a merging process, cannibal black holes, and so on. Even the Moon and the Earth are, of course, gravitationally connected. Connection. This is how astronomers found our Unicorn black hole. Astronomers led by Tharindu Jayasinghe, a doctoral student and presidential fellow at The Ohio State University, were searching for bright stars accompanied by non-interacting black holes, which are black holes that aren't tugging material off their stellar companions, when they suddenly saw signs of the Unicorn around a red giant star in Monoceros. Jayasinghe and his colleagues spotted just this type of gravitational influence, known as a tidal distortion, affecting a bright dying star called V723 Mon. This hint prompted the team to search for the signs of the star's potential companion, which had to be both much less luminous and significantly more massive than the giant V723 Mon. The tidal tug of the companion was visible in observations captured by the Kilo Degree Extremely Little Telescope, KELT, the All-Sky Automated Survey, ASAS, and NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, TESS. The team also confirmed the detection with follow-up observations from the remote observatory Atacama Desert Road, the Neil Gerald Swift Observatory, and the Keck Observatory, among others. As a result, they concluded that the bright red giant V723 Mon has a dark, massive companion that is a good candidate for the closest known black hole, according to the study. So the unicorn has a companion, a bloated red giant star that's nearing the end of its life. Our sun will swell up as a red giant in about 5 billion years. Just as the moon's gravity distorts the Earth's oceans, causing the seas to bulge towards and away from the moon, producing high tides, so does the black hole distort the star into a football-like shape with one axis longer than the other. Study co-author Todd Thompson, chair of the Ohio State's Astronomy Department, said in a statement, "The simplest explanation is that it's a black hole, and in this case, the simplest explanation is the most likely one." The unicorn's low mass also places it in the mysterious mass gap between the most massive neutron stars, roughly 2.2 times the mass of the Sun, and the smallest black holes, roughly 5 times the mass of the Sun. Let's talk a minute about this topic. What exactly is the mass gap? Some decades ago, astronomers noticed something odd with black holes. While a variety of possible black holes had been found in our galaxy, none appeared to fall below a certain size. There seemed to be a dearth of black holes below 5 solar masses. Statistically, this was very significant. Since Ozel, an astrophysicist at the University of Arizona, published a paper on the problem in 2010, this so-called mass gap has gone unexplained. Even after the LIGO and Virgo gravitational wave detectors started to identify dozens of hidden black holes, including a few surprises, the mass gap appeared to hold firm. Was it just a case? In time, astrophysicists such as Ozel began to wonder, are small black holes just hard to find, or might not they exist at all? It was a hard question to answer, yet it is important to establish observationally whether this gap is real or whether it is an observational artifact. Now, recent discoveries are beginning to suggest the latter might be the case. Over the last 2 years, researchers have found several possible black holes in the mass gap. The unicorn black hole is one of them. That's why it's so important for our understanding of the universe. The discovery, if confirmed, since by now the unicorn is simply a candidate black hole, would help illuminate the fine distinction that nature makes at the end of a massive star's life. When a giant star exhausts its fuel, the star's mass flows inward and its core collapses. If the incoming mass can explode and overcome the star's gravitational force, it bursts into a supernova. But if not, if there's just too much mass, the star collapses in on itself and forms a black hole. Exactly what determines whether a star explodes as a supernova or collapses into a black hole isn't clear. The actual physics of the supernova explosion is a huge unknown, said Thompson. The black hole mass gap could be a vital clue to that process. The problem is that at these lower masses, it's hard to tell the difference between a black hole and a neutron star, since the latter can bulk up to a theoretical maximum of 3 solar masses. And depending on the conditions, neutron stars can appear dark as well. In fact, if a neutron star is a pulsar with a beam pointed at you, it does some very obvious things, and you can surely tell that it is a pulsar. But if it is not, it can be very difficult to separate it from a black hole. If this discovery turns out not to be a black hole, and especially if the other candidates don't hold up to scrutiny either, then perhaps black holes simply do not form below 5 solar masses. Such a revelation would carry significant implications for our understanding of supernova physics and for our understanding of the universe in general. But if the unicorn really is a black hole, it could be one of many in this gap waiting to be discovered and studied. That's what's exciting about this paper, says Ozel. If we come to a point where we know more than one or two of these objects, then we can understand what types of processes led to these smaller mass black holes. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Do you believe in unicorns? What do you think about this video? Let us know in the comments below. See you next time on the channel.